County, Georgia, weighing in at 350 pounds, the Big Boss Man.
Big Boss Man is here to serve law, order, and justice, and he will not be bought.
A former tag champion, a former hardcore champion, and a WWE Hall of Famer.
Someone take that nightstick from Big Boss Man. He is mad with power.
Legendary Dusty Rhodes.
He's just a common man. And his opponent from Austin, Texas, weighing in at 270 pounds, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes.
It is time to get a dream, hold on to it, and shoot for the sky. The American Dream has arrived on the big stage.
This will surely be a true mano a mano test. It's amazing. For more than 50 years, men and women have entered this ring all in the name of greatness to see who is truly the best. I think when it's all said and done, we'll be talking about this match for a long time.
And man, I never get tired of watching these guys compete.
Taking out the knee!
Oh man.
That'll destroy your ligaments.
Look at this. Plenty of fight left.
Not even close.
Oof. Nasty left hook.
Woo-wee.
The American Dream is shaking and baking.
Oh boy, he is rolling.
Big elbow.
Big Boss Man starting to sweat.
If he can hold the line here, he'll be in a good position.
Bionic elbow
right to the forehead.
Set him up for the...
How did Boss Man turn that one around?
Oh, leg sweep.
Nicely done.
Knife edge, and Dusty Rhodes makes the cover.
And Big Boss Man easily powers out.
Yeah, seemed to be just testing the waters a bit there. Many people know that the American Dream Dusty Rhodes grew up in Texas and was the son of a plumber. What many don't know is that before Rhodes was known as Sports Entertainment, he played professional football and put on the pads for the AFL's Boston Patriots and the Continental Football League's Hartford Charter Oaks.
Oh no, inverted atomic drop.
Big Boss Man starting to lose some steam.
A change of strategy has to be his next move.
Nice job by Dusty Rhodes there.
What's he got in mind?
Atomic drop, ooh. Couple of jabs. Gonna follow it up with a big right hand.
Oh. Can he do it here?
One, two,
and wow, and Big Boss Man finds a way to stay in this. Gotta be careful not to get counted out here.
Set him up.
Russian leg sweep.
Nicely done.
Four. Five.
How did Bob?
Boss Man turn that one around.
Six. Seven.
Russian leg sweep.
Eight.
Bringing it back between the ropes. Look at the dream, the American dream. Dusty Rhodes going up top.
Four.
We'll see if Dusty Rhodes' mind games take root here.
Five. Six.
Gotta wonder how this is gonna end, Byron.
It's not gonna be good.
Didn't see that one coming.
I don't think anybody did, Michael.
Oh, he may get the three count right there.
One, two, three.
Dusty Rhodes with the victory.
Corey, we got to take a look at this action.
Look at him go. Who could forget this?
It's all over and Dusty Rhodes stands victorious.
That is what I like to call a statement win, Michael.
What an incredible moment here at the Royal Rumble. Here comes Jake the Snake.
The following contest is a championship first round match, making his way to the ring from Stone Mountain, Georgia, weighing in at 249 pounds, Jake the Snake.
There's a reason Saxton dished out money to sit here tonight and watch this on pay-per-view.
And his opponent from Miami, Florida, weighing in at 287 pounds, the bad guy, Razor Ramon.
Let's focus on one of the greatest superstars to ever compete on pay-per-view. Hey, remember his incredible ladder match at WrestleMania 10 against Shawn Michaels?
Who can forget that? It was a defining moment in WWE history, and it paved the way for some of the greatest superstars of this era. I was in attendance in Pittsburgh for the rematch, the second ladder match between Randy.
And you know, Razor and I have something in common. We both ooze machismo.
Okay, maybe just Razor.
Byron, you can somehow make the sun less cool.
Razor Ramon is famous for his love of the gold he wears around his neck. But more than anything, Razor loves winning, and he will carve you up to do it.
Man, this card is just packed with so many great matches, and this one is definitely among the most anticipated, I'd say.
Down with the vertical suplex.
Oh, Corey, he unloaded there. Running Bulldog.
Ooh, no luck against Ramon there.
Jake Roberts is a showman, but this might be a little over the top.
Oh, ooh, what a knee lift.
Somebody better check his nose.
A menacing onslaught from Jake the Snake. And here comes Jake the Snake.
Oh, yeah, here's Razor Ramon.
He's bringing it back inside the ring now.
Six.
I don't know what he has planned out here, but he must be mindful of the referee's count.
Kick to the gut and, oh, brutal forearm.
Two. Three.
Set up for the side rushing leg sweep.
Ooh, no luck against Ramon there.
Six. Seven.
Now look at his aggression, just pure brutality.
Come on, easy.
Eight.
SummerSlam 1994 will always be a memorable night for Razor Ramon and for the city of Chicago as Ramon took on double champion Diesel. Big Daddy Cool was the Intercontinental Champion and one half of the World Tag Team Champions with Shawn Michaels. Now while HBK was in Diesel's corner, Ramon rolled into the United Center with Chicago Bears legend Walter Payton as his corner man.
What a forearm!
Jake Roberts not where he wants to be right now.
He had to be prepared to take some damage tonight.
No one was synonymous with the Intercontinental Championship like Razor Ramon was in the mid-90s. The bad guy held the championship on several occasions with one of the highest profile victories coming at SummerSlam 94 over the 7-footer Diesel.
It was a wild match for the Intercontinental Championship. And you can bet thanks to the bad guy and sweetness Walter Payton, it was a rough night in the Windy City for Big Daddy Cool and the Heartbreak Kid.
What a throw!
Right to the gut!
All on the apron, lifting it up into the ring!
This is not where you want to be.
Oh, great display of strength with the suplex.
Razor is not holding back right now.
Bam, suplex. Jake the Snake Roberts doing a great job turning that around. Razor Ramon is in a tough spot right now.
He's getting beaten up out there, but staying strong.
Man, this has been a great matchup.
Oh, yeah, here's Razor Ramon.
Nothing fancy here.
Oh, God, jarring impact.
And Jake Roberts making him think twice.
A face buster knee smash.
That looks painful.
to the outside, which will start the referee's count.
Set up for the side Russian leg sweep.
Two.
What a punch!
Three.
A quick reversal by Razor Ramon.
And another reversal.
Seems like we're back where we began, Michael.
Side Russian leg sweep.
Oh, perfect form.
Five.
And the snake is slithering. Something fierce right here.
Six. Seven.
Absolute dominance.
Three.
Really just laying it in.
Now back to the ring.
Four.
Scoop slam. A leverage pin here.
Hey, it's only cheating if you get caught.
One, two,
this battle's not over yet.
Jake shakes off attacks like that in his sleep.
He's hurting now.
If he doesn't get out of that corner, he's gonna be hurting even worse.
If I was Razor, I would think twice before I celebrated too much. At least not yet.
Oh, a nasty shot to the throat.
Uh-oh. The bad guy's setting up.
From way up high, here we go.
Here's Razor Ramon's chance to take.
That should do it right there.
One, two, three.
Ramon with the win.
That was impressive. And here's another peek of the moves you saw in that match.
Remember this? Check him out here. And the Macho Man.
Life is all about options, Byron Saxton, and when your one option is a maniac and the other one is limousine riding, jet flying, kiss stealing, wheeling dealing, you gotta think long and hard about spending the night with the Nature Boy.
Well, I got a feeling that maniac is going to smash the face of the Nature Boy.
Might be the oldest ride, but it's still got the longest line. One of the greatest pay-per-view performers in the history of WWE.
And his opponent from Sarasota, Florida, weighing in at 239 pounds, Macho Man Randy Savage.
Randy Savage's opponent here tonight, the Nature Boy Ric Flair, who actually had the audacity, Corey, to claim that he Miss Elizabeth before the Macho Man.
You can't prove that Flair's lying, Saxton. Savage gained a measure of redemption at WrestleMania 8.
Perhaps history will repeat itself one more time.
Things are going to get very physical between these two. The endless humiliation, disrespect, and sneak attacks. I think Ric Flair will learn he took things too far in antagonizing the Macho Man.
If you're Ric Flair, you can never take things too far. Frankly, I'm concerned for the well-being of the Nature Boy. Savage looks like a man possessed out there. A referee should have the local authorities on speed dial in case Macho Man gets out of control.
Someone's gonna be walking funny after that.
Watch this here. Oh my, down with authority. Strike punch.
There he goes to the outside.
Remember though, there are no timeouts in WWE.
That's a good way to make your presence felt.
Oh, stomping away.
Oh, look at this aggression, just pure brutality.
Oh, easy.
Randy Savage with a nice reversal. Momentum not on the Nature Boy's side.
If he planned for this, it could still rally.
To the back. He has something big planned.
Double underhook suplex.
Just raking the face. Ripping in the eyes and the face.
All right, guys, Randy Savage taking full advantage.
Oh, yeah.
Gotta be careful not to get counted out here.
Oh, Corey, he unloaded there.
Two. Three.
Randy, Macho Man Savage is one of the most intense and unpredictable competitors to ever enter the ring. Four. Bringing it back into the ring.
Got the leg. Bang and screw.
That'll tear your knee up.
Here's your favorite, Corey.
Brilliant.
Suplex. Woo!
Style and profile, and doing it better than anyone ever. The Nature Boy.
Woo!
Just ruthless.
And now it's Macho Man losing some steam.
Yeah, he needs to make an adjustment here.
Oh, the torque on the knee!
Ric Flair is taking control. Nature Boy is going on next round on him. Oh my God. Oh! Crushing the knee here. And no luck against Flair there.
Are you surprised?
Oh, what a clothesline.
Forcefully delivered. Not sure Ric Flair should be playing to the crowd right here, but try telling him that.
And here comes Nate.
Woo! Time to style and profile.
And he makes it to the ropes.
Did you really doubt that he would? Come on, Cole.
Not stopping the leg.
Just nasty.
Randy Savage with a nice reversal.
Max Randall finds the mark.
What does Ric Flair need to do now to remain a fat?
Is that enough for the win?
Yeah, he's got a lot left in him.
He just powered out there, Cole.
Caught off guard.
They call him the Macho Man for a reason, I guess.
Oh, on the apron, lifting it up into the ring. Bam, suplex.
Look, Ric Flair is on the attack now.
Not where you want to be at this point in the match, guys.
Definitely not.
Got the leg.
Banging screw.
That'll tear your knee up.
Randy Savage is too fast for him.
Oh, no.
I'm afraid so, Cole. This is gonna be great.
Oh, clothesline!
All right, guys, Randy Savage taking full advantage.
Oh, yeah.
Look at this.
Down to the floor.
I don't know what he has planned out here, but he must be mindful of the referee's count.
Oh, kick right in the gut.
Ric Flair taking a beating here.
He was the favorite for this match, but that's changing rapidly.
The Nature Boy needs to rely on his trademark stamina right now. Randy Savage isn't being shy, that's for sure.
Randy Savage, the cream of the crop.
Somebody unleashed the Savage.
Enough already. Double axe handles.
And he's heading back in. Look at this, Macho Man's going upstairs.
From the top rope!
Ric Flair has him. And the ropes break this one up.
Great ring awareness there, Michael.
Nice leg pick.
Knee drop. He's in big trouble.
Uh-oh, position in.
Measuring. Drop right to the jaw. He may get the three count right there. And an earful.
Yeah, there's a reason they call him Macho, folks. And you just saw it right there.
Looking for the finish.
And the Nature Boy looking to put the finishing touches on this matchup.
It's going
to
be a party tonight.
The figure four.
Flair going to make his opponent. Submit.
Nate with the figure four in. Ric Flair gets the win. Another Hall of Fame moment from Ric Flair's win.
Man, this was great. He's getting it done here.